Guys, we have started with software testing, the fourth unit. Into the previous chapter, we covered basic idea about software testing process, testing scenarios, and black box testing. Now we are continuing our session with next part called as what white box testing. We'll just in the quickest movement we will brush up few parts. So what is software testing? It's just a process which is used to find out the problems, errors, bugs from the software, or sometimes it is referred as it is a process used to identify whether the software is working correctly, complete, and the quality expected from the end users or not. So simply it is a process of executing means conducting a program, running a program or the applications which is under positive and negative conditions by it's a manual or automated means the testing you can perform either manual or automated, or it may be a combination of that. And software testing is nothing but simply checking whether it's a functions properly working or not, whether it is as per the specifications or not, and whether its a performance is as per expectations or not. We call it that entire process as a software testing. Then why there is need to go for the software testing? Software testing is important as it may cause mission failures, impact on operational performance and reliability if not done properly. Means if you are not tested the software properly, and without testing, whatever developer has developed, if you give it to the end user, when end user is using the product and he finds the problems, if the system get downs, it may create a lot of problems. So to avoid such a situations, it is necessary to do it proper testing before giving the product to end user. So effective software testing delivers quality software product satisfying the user requirement, needs and expectations. So who can work as a tester, or who should perform the test? So the person who has developed the product and also the separate independent team. That should be a combination of that, means developer itself plus some separate independent testers, and combination of these will perform a testing that gives a better idea about the software testing and its scenarios. So at the start of a session we have covered the three basic parts as a problems in the software testing. One is known as error, second is bug, failure and fault. So error, human action that produces the incorrect results. Second, we have talk about simplest part we have covered is person makes an error that creates a fault in software. So because of error, there is a fault in the software, and because of that fault, it creates a failure for the operation. So that causes a failure in the operation, and because of this failure there may be a wrong scenario in the system. So who is a software tester? Software tester is the one who performs testings and find out bugs if they exist in the tested application. Means the person who tests the product known as a software tester, and the reason behind performing the testing is to find out the problems, errors, bugs and defect, if any, from the software or the application which is under testing scenario. This was the basic idea. Now we are starting with our actual point, that is white box testing. As the name suggests, white box testing means the box which is open to you and you are going to perform. Means what is inside the box is visible to you. So what is inside the box means the code. So you must aware about the code. So whenever I am talking about the code means maybe any language you have written, C, CPP, Java, .NET, any programming language, even Python, any programming language, the code you have written is now visible to you. In black box testing, the code is not visible to you. But in white box testing, the basic idea is code is visible to you means you can play with the code. So whenever I'm talking about the code, that code consists of the two parts. One is it's a control flow and second is a data flow. Now control flow means your program always executes in a proper sequence. That sequence is known as line by line code execution. But when the program goes line by line execution, if some conditions come, so with reference to that conditions, it may take it may take a next path. We call that as a control flow. Second is data flow testing. Now, what is meaning of data flow testing? Suppose in your programming language, if I take an example of a Java, and you have declared a variable integer a is equal to 10. You have declared this variable of a type integer, name of that integer a, and assign a value as a 10. And throughout the program, without performing any manipulation with an integer a, whether its a value same or not, that performance will be checked, called as what, data flow based testing. And if you write somewhere in the programming a++, means it gives an increment to the value a. Earlier in declaration you said as a 10, after a++ it should have some values increment into the a. Similarly with the decorations or any arithmetical operations, if you perform with that, it must be going to that scenario or not. It is a part of a data flow testing. So whenever I am talking about the program, the structure is open to you. So it is known as a structural testing also. So remember, white box testing is also known as structural testing, whereas a black box testing we studied as a behavioral testing or performance testing. But in case of white box testing, we are going to call it as a structural testing. So white box testing concerned with implementation of the program, remember this part, and it deals with internal structure and logic of the program. So it is known as structural testing. And to perform the white box testing, we have a two options here, means the two approaches here. One is control flow testing and second is data flow testing. Now control flow based testing means simply what we can see. We'll remember, control flow testing is a type of structural testing performed by the programmer to test the code written by them. Whereas data flow based testing, it is a basic idea, the definition of variables and their usage can be tested. So let's talk about the first. What is control flow testing? Control flow testing is, as I rightly said, is a type of structural testing performed by the programmer to test the code written by them. A node represents block of statement that is executed together. H in bracket I comma j, that is transfer of control from I to j. Node in the block whose first statement is start statement and it is start node of the graph. Node in the block those last statement is exit statement is called as the exit node, and the path of the sequence of the node is n1, n2, n3 to nk. So simply remember, this is a basic path testing, means whatever the program you have written, that each line is executed or not, that will be get tested. And whatever the parts we have used here as a node, so node is nothing but it represents one or more procedural statement. H, they represent the flow of control in the program, edge or link. And decision node, a node with more than one arrow leaving is called as a decision node. Junction node, exactly opposite to the decision node, a node with more than one arrow entering in its, we are calling it as what, junction node. And regions, areas bounded by the edges, and nodes are called a region. So simply remember, we are going to represent the control flow based testing with control flow graph. You might have studied this control flow graph in analysis and design subject, so I'll not waste much of time, but if you need, you can refer my blog. I have a separate presentation on that. Okay, now moving towards the next part, called as what, a data flow testing. So data flow testing okay, so remember, as I said rightly to you, control flow graph is, it's a basically a graph which is represented based on a program. Suppose in a program you have start to end 11 points. So 1 to 11 points will be drawn, starting from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If there is a conditional statement, based on the condition, true condition, false condition, we have a separate nodes, and these nodes will be connected to each other. That is what we are calling control flow graph. Is it clear? Okay, now moving towards the next part of the syllabus, called as a data flow based testing. Now what is data flow based testing? As I said, it is a basic idea that the definition of variable and their usage can be tested, means I have taken the simple example. In a programming language, you have said as integer a is equal to 10. So what you have used, a variable a of which type integer, and value you have assigned is 10. So without any manipulation, the value a must be 10 throughout the program, and whether it is yes or no, that will be tested under data flow testing. If you have some conditions in the program like a plus plus, value should be incremented, a minus minus, value should be decremented, a plus a, like this arithmetic operations you have said. So based on that, the new value should be assigned to the program, and whether these values are going to get assigned or not, it is get tested under the value as a data flow based testing. So in this criteria, graph of the program is first constructed, just similar to the control flow testing. Again, we are going to draw control flow graph. Statements in the node represent block of the node, each variable occurring in it. For each node, whatever the values you have assigned, we will assign that values. For first, second line, we declare the variable. So the second node, I is equal to a is equal to 10 is the value I have assigned. Then next, variable occurrence can be following type: definition of the variable and computational use of the variables. So based on that, their values remain same or not, unless until any operation comes. That part we are calling as a data flow based testing. So what we covered so far, we have covered the white box testing that can be done with the two style. One is a control flow testing and second is a data flow testing. So basically white box testing is nothing but the structural testing. The entire box, the glass is open to you. So what is inside that box is open to you. We are calling it a structure. Structure based as in a program. And in program you have written the code. And in code you have some steps written in some logical syntax. So each and everything we will check. So in program, basically there are two types of the flows. One is a control flow. Second is a data flow. Control flow means line by line execution. And data flow means whatever the values, whatever the variables you have declared in the program is going to get tested, we call as a white box testing. Any doubt so far? Okay, now we will move to the next part of the chapter called as what? Testing process. So what does the testing process? Testing process is an activity before final the software is going to get delivered. So it has a responsibility. So this is the responsibility of a testing, is make sure that there is no problems in the product developed by the developer before going to hand over the product to the end users. To detect errors, after they introduce every phase ending with a verification activity such as reviews, testing process focuses on how testing should be performed for any projects. So the basic idea behind the testing is to find out all possible problems. So is any criteria there, or is any perfect level, or what we can say, method to implement the testing? So rather waiting for testing as a separate phase, start the testing as early as possible. So we might have studied this in the first chapter. One separate model is there called as V&V model, which is known as verification and validation model. So what does this model? Don't wait separate for the testing phase. After analysis, start testing. After designing, start testing. After coding, start immediately testing. So the testing can be implemented at a different parts, and implementing testing at a different part, this process we are calling as different levels of testing. Now starting with the different levels of testing is what we can say. Let's take simplest part to understand. There are four levels of testing. One is called as a unit testing, second is integration testing, third is system testing, and fourth is user acceptance testing. Sometimes it is referred as only acceptance testing, but always remember is as a user acceptance testing. Now the first level means the program is written by the developer. So developer writes the code. After writing the code, developer only performs some kind of a testing, whether whatever he has written is executing the same output or not. That we are calling simply as a unit testing. Suppose I take a simple example, calculator. I divided this calculator project to different teams: A team, B team, C team, and D team. A team is working on one module called as addition, B team working on subtraction, C team is working on multiplication, and D team is working on division. And A team only has developed the software for the addition. They have given the input and they are performing the, they are checking the output. So I'm calling it as a simply unit testing. And unit testing is now white box testing because the structure is open to them. Now addition module is perfect. Now they are moving towards the next module. What they will do? They will integrate addition module with subtraction module and they will perform the testing. We are calling as a integration module or module testing. Means there are the two different modules, addition and subtraction. Now they are combining addition and subtraction together and they are performing the testing. We are calling as a integration testing. In some books we will call it as a module testing also. So the two or different modules are combined together to perform, to check its performance. We are calling as a integration testing. Now next part is system testing. So I will go for incremental integration testing. Means I have started with the unit testing addition. Next I go on for the next module called as a subtraction. I combine the two modules, addition and subtraction, and I have combined the testing, we call as a integration testing. Now I repeat the process. After adding subtraction, I will go for multiplication. Now I have three modules which I have combined together and I am performing, still I am calling it as a integration testing. So this process will be repeated till you will get the final product, whatever in your system. So in my case of a system, I have only four modules, addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So when all these four modules are combined together and then I am performing the testing, that type of a testing I am calling as a system testing. Now first two types of levels of a testing, unit testing, integration testing, where may be a code open to all, so we are calling as a simply white box testing. But in case of system testing, there may be or may not be, so we will call it as one black box testing. After this, the entire system is ready. It may be assured by the tester by performing system testing is that the entire calculator is ready. It has all features what is expected by the user and all modules expected by the user. Now it is said to the end user by the team that your product is ready, and before accepting the product by the user, perform your testing. That is called as what? User acceptance testing. Now that user will perform the testing in two style, maybe visiting to the organization and okay, let's give a demo to me, and that demo is conducted at organization itself. We call it as a alpha testing. Or it might be the case that the company who has developed the product will go towards the client, towards the end user, and they will install the product at a user side and will give the demo. We will call it as one beta testing. So alpha and beta are the types of acceptance testing. So are you clear with the levels of testing? Remember, unit testing, integration testing, system testing and user acceptance testing. And it is done in this simplest style. User needs acceptance testing, a requirement system testing, design integration testing, and the code simple final unit testing. This diagram is very important, you have to remember this. So are you clear? Unit testing, in this individual unit of the code is tested to determine if they are fit for the use. It is the smallest testable part of the application, like function, procedure, classes, etc. And unit test and return and run by the developer, which ensures the code meets its design. So the one who has developed only has to perform the testing, white box testing. Second is integration testing. It occurs after unit testing. Means once your unit is done, next it is going towards, if we continue with the example, two different models like addition and subtractions are ready by different teams. Now I am going to combine them and performing testing. I am calling it as one integration testing. So it occurs after unit testing. In this, individual unit or modules are combined and tested as group to verify integrated system is ready for system testing, and it is done by specific integration testers or test teams. Next is system testing. It is conducted on complete integrated system to evaluate the system's compliance with its specified requirement. It comes under the black box testing, so no need to have the internal logic of the code. So first two levels, that is unit testing and integration testing, comes as a part of white box testing. Next, system testing comes as a part of black box testing. And at the last, user acceptance testing, it is test conducted to determine if the requirements of the specifications or contract are in the product or not, which is delivered, which is going to deliver to the end user, and it is done by end user or customer. So it is known as user acceptance testing, and it has a two different types, as I rightly mentioned, alpha testing and beta testing. Any doubt so far? Okay, now we are moving towards the next part, called as what? Test planning. So what does the test planning? It is a document, basically. Test plan is a document which is used for entire testing activities. It defines the scope, approach to be taken, and schedule of the testing, as well as it identifies the test items for entire testing process. So simply remember, test plan is nothing but one separate document which will help us, the testers, how to perform the testing. So again, it was some bit lengthy session. So what we will do, we'll take a pause here, and in the next part we will start to cover about the testing planning. Till then, enjoy the parts. Thank you.